Hello learners, our today's session is on development bank, and in this session we will cover the meaning of development banks, difference between commercial bank and development banks, and different types of development banks in India. So basically, banks in India can be categorized in three segments: scheduled banks, non-scheduled banks, and development banks. Scheduled banks are those banks which are listed in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. Commercial banks and cooperative banks come under this. Next is the non-scheduled banks. Non-scheduled banks are those banks which are not listed in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. And next is the development banks. Development banks are the special financial institutions. And our today's discussion is on this development banks. All these banks, they are controlled by RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. RBI is the central bank, and it was established in 1st January 1935. It is the apex bank, so we can say that it is the head of all the banks, and it regulate and monitor the activities of all the banks in India. So these are the different types of banks in India. Now we'll start with the development banks. What is the meaning of development banks? Development banks are special financial institutions. They provide medium and long-term finance to industry, agriculture, and other key sectors. In other key sectors include the foreign trade, export-import, and the housing sectors. They provide medium and long-term finance to these sectors, industry, agriculture, and other sectors. And they provide finance to both public and private sector. They provide credit facility, they provide loan to both public and private industries. Development bank are multi-purpose financial institutions. They do term lending, investment in securities, and other activities. Besides providing the financial assistance, they provide the managerial as well as technical assistance also. Development banks are also known as term lending institutions or development finance institutions. Next is the definition of development bank. A development bank may be defined as a financial institution concerned with providing all types of financial assistance, medium as well as long terms to business units. So they provide medium as well as long term financial assistance to the industries, both public and private industries. So next is the difference between commercial banks and the development bank. So here is the table of comparison between commercial bank and development banks. So first difference is commercial banks, they are financial institutions, whereas development banks, they are multi-purpose financial institutions. The purpose of commercial bank is to make profit through the interest earned by lending at high rate of interest, whereas development bank, purpose of development bank is to achieve social profit through affecting development projects. Development bank, commercial banks are formed under the Companies Act as banking companies. And whereas the development banks, they set up under the special act passed by the government. The target clientele of commercial banks is individual and business entities, means they provide, they lend to the individuals and business entities, whereas the development banks, they lend to the government and industries. Commercial bank raise funds or finance through the public deposit, which are payable on demand. Whereas development bank, they raise funds through the selling of securities like shares, debentures, and they borrow and get grants from the government also. Sector targets. Commercial bank basically target the masses, or you can say the general public, as they have different products to offer. Whereas the development bank, they target the development sector, like housing sector, agriculture sector, industrial sectors. So they target development sector. Commercial bank provides short-term and medium-term loans, whereas the development banks, they provide medium-term and long-term loans. Commercial banks provide the check facilities for making and withdrawal of deposit, but development banks do not offer such check facilities. So this is the difference between the commercial banks and development banks. Next is the different development banks in India. So in India, there are industrial development bank, agriculture development bank, export import development bank, housing development bank. In under industrial development banks come the All India level development bank and state level development banks. So we will study each this development bank one by one. First come the industrial development banks, and in which first is the Industrial Financial Corporation of India, IFCI. After independence, IFCI was the first development bank established in India. So it was set up in 1948 under the Industrial Finance Corporation Act. And the main objective of this bank is to provide medium and long-term loans to the company to meet their capital requirements. They provide loan for maximum period of 25 years, and IFCI also encourage loan for setting up new industrial projects and also loan for expansion of existing units, diversification, modernization, and renovation. They provide underwriting facility also. Now, what is underwriting facility? As per the Companies Act, when the company subscribe their share, offer their share to the public, then 90% of the subscription must be subscribed by the public. Otherwise, their subscription will be cancelled. So in underwriting facility, the underwriter ensure, underwriter guarantees the minimum subscription. It means he underwriters ensure that if public will not purchase the share, they will purchase the shares or the debentures to meet the minimum requirement, and that is of 90%. So IFCI provide these facilities, these underwriting facilities to the companies also. And it also gives security for import of capital goods. So when the companies, they import capital goods, then IFC provides security for them also. So this is about the IFCI. Next is the next development bank is Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, ICICI. And it was set up in 1955 under the joint agreement of USA, UK, and India. The special feature of ICICI was that it was privately owned and provide financial assistance to the private sector industries only. Whereas IFCI, that provide the financial assistance to the public sector industries. But for the private sector, this ICICI come into existence. And besides providing financial assistance, it provides managerial, technical, and administrative assistance also. So they provide managerial assistance, technical assistance, and other administrative assistance also to the industries. In 2002, ICICI was converted into ICICI Bank. Now it has no obligation of project financing. So now these ICICI Bank, they are converted into, they get the license of commercial bank. So now they are not providing the project financing. Next is the Industrial Development Bank of India, IDBI. And it was established in 1964 by an Act of Parliament as a wholly owned subsidiary of RBI. But in 1976, the ownership of IDBI was transferred to the Government of India. IDBI provides financial assistance either directly or through some specified financial institutions. Means they provide direct financial assistance or they also refinance. Refinance means they give financial assistance to those financial institutions which are engaged, which provide, which give loan to the industries like IFCI and SFCs, etc. So they provide finance as well as refinance facility also. It provides the technical and managerial assistance to industries. And in 2004, IDBI was also converted into IDBI Bank. but it has still the obligation of carrying its project financing duties. So this bank, so this IDBI, this development bank, also converted into the commercial bank in 2004. Next industrial development bank is Small Industrial Development Bank of India, SIDBI. And it was established in 1989, and it provides financial assistance to small scale industries. For small scale industries, SIDBI came into existence in 1989. Besides providing financial assistance, they also provide the facility of marketing of goods of the small scale industry. They do marketing of the products of the small scale industry also, and they also help in employment generation by giving special assistance to labor intensive small scale industries. Next is the Micro Units Development and Refinance Agency, that is the Mudra Bank. The Mudra Bank was set up under the Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana scheme, and it was inaugurated by launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 8th April 2015, and about 5.77 crore small businesses have been identified as its target clients. The principal objective of this bank is to provide loans to small manufacturing units, shopkeepers and street vendors at low interest rate under these three schemes, these Shishu, Kishore, Tarun. And under Shishu scheme, the loan up to rupees 50,000 is given, under Kishore up to rupees 5 lakh, and under Tarun loan up to rupees 10 lakh is given. Next comes the State Financial Corporation. Now this is the State Industrial Development Bank. The previous banks were the all India level banks. Now comes the state level development bank. And here comes the State Financial Corporation. And it was established in 1951 under the State Financial Corporation Act with the specific purpose for promotion and balanced development of each state. So for the state's development, these development banks were established. The first state financial corporation was formed in 1953 in Punjab, and they provide financial assistance to small and medium-sized industries, and they provide loan to public, private companies, cooperative society, partnership firms, and sole traders. And at present, 18 state financial corporations are working in India, in the different states of India. 18 these state financial corporations are working now. Next comes the State Industrial Development Corporation. State Industrial Development Corporation established in 1995 under the Companies Act 1956. They provide finance to the medium and large industry. Besides providing finance, these institutions perform a variety of functions such as arranging for land, roads, license for industrial units, sponsoring the establishment of each unit, especially in backward areas, etc. And at present, there are 28 state industrial development corporations are working in India. So these are the industrial development banks. Next come the Agricultural Development Bank, and it includes, for example, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. It is called NABARD. NABARD was established in India to bring the agriculture reforms. And it was established in 12th July 1982 by the Special Act of Parliament. And it provides refinance credit for the promotion of agriculture, cottage industry, small scale industry, and village industry in rural areas. The basic objective of NABARD was to uplift rural India by increasing the credit flow for elevation of agriculture and rural non-farm sectors. And NABARD supervised the state cooperative banks, district cooperative, central banks, and regional rural banks. So So the NABARD, so these banks are under the supervision of NABARD. Next is the Export Import Development Bank, and it includes Exim Bank. Exim Bank was set up in 1982 under Export Import Bank of India Act. And this bank was established to encourage the foreign trade of India. The main objective of this bank is to arrange funds for the companies which are dealing in export-import businesses. In addition to these financial services, they provide some value-added information, advisory and support services, which enable exporters to evaluate the international risk, exploit export opportunities, and improve competitiveness. So besides the providing funds to the industries which are dealing in export import, they provide non-financial assistance also. Next is the Housing Development Bank, and it includes the National Housing Bank. Was established in 1988 as a wholly owned subsidiary of RBI under the National Housing Bank Act 1987. And the National Housing Bank is the apex financial institution for the development of housing sector in India. The main objective of this bank is to promote a sound, healthy, viable, and cost-effective housing finance system to cater all the segments of the population. Currently, National Housing Banks offer two housing schemes under the Housing for All by 2022 program of the government. And these schemes are Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and Rural Housing Interest Subsidy Scheme. The Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana was launched in 2015 by Prime Minister Narendra Modi with an aim to provide affordable housing to urban poor with the basic amenities such as water connection, toilet facilities, and 24/7 power supply. Whereas the Rural Housing Interest Subsidy Scheme was launched with an objective to provide pakka houses by 2022 to all those without a home and to those living in kacha houses. So Rural Housing Interest Subsidy Scheme also focuses on providing assistance to households in rural areas to construct, improve, or repair their existing dwellings or their existing place where they live. So learners, this is all about the development bank. I hope this presentation gives you some insights about the development bank and how these development banks are contributing in the economic development of the country. So that's all for this session. Thank you.